Okay, reproductive barriers. So there's pretty much two basic types of reproductive barriers. Those fall into the categories of, you know, prezygotic or postzygotic. Zygotic meaning like a zygote, meaning like a fertilized egg. So prezygotic will be, you know, before the egg is fertilized, and postzygotic will be after the egg is fertilized. So prezygotic barriers, obviously habitat, you know, if they don't share the same habitat, you know, if they're different in different locations, obviously they won't be able to mate. temporal isolation kind of refers to, you know, species not really breeding at the same time of day or the same time of year, or, you know, even same time of season, or these kind of things. You know, it's just when certain species tend to mate. Behavioral issues can arise as well, behavioral isolation, and this can arise when there's different mating habits, such as mating calls or, you know, mating courtship displays or these kind of things. Mechanical barriers are, you know, just as it sounds, things just don't match up. The genitals just don't seem to match up. Gametic isolation can be the actual sperm and egg cannot fuse. They cannot, you know, fertilize an actual viable zygote. And this could be, you know, the sperm can't survive in the reproductive tract or, you know, any of those kind of things. Postzygotic, now this is after the egg has been fertilized. We have hybrid viability. And that means, you know, is the hybrid even viable? Can it even survive? For example, you know, they can say they mate and then they make a hybrid. This hybrid could be very frail or could die easily, or, you know, weak lungs or those kind of things. Hybrid breakdown, that's actually typically seen in plants, but this means like each subsequent generation just gets weaker and weaker until it just doesn't exist. Hybrid fertility, the perfect example for this would be a mule. You know, we have a horse and you know, that's when the horse mates with a donkey and it becomes a mule. But the mule is, you know, perfectly fine. It's not, you know, I mean, it's a viable offspring, but it is infertile and it can't have, you know, offspring. And this is the major difference between the prezygotic and the postzygotic reproductive isolation.